Yes, you are welcome to this lesson. We are continuing to look at how ions are formed. And specifically, we are looking at how cations are formed. In the previous video, we looked at how beryllium ion is formed. And we journeyed through this slide, and we said that there are four protons in a beryllium atom. Why? Because atomic number is four. And since there are four protons, there are also four electrons because it is a neutral atom. Then the electronic configuration is 2 to 2. The arrangement of those four electrons is 2 to 2 because the first energy level should carry a maximum of only 2 electrons. The neutral number is 5. Okay? Then we say that this atom is not stable, so it has to gain stability by losing these 2 electrons or gaining 6 electrons to add on this to make it 8. But it is easier to lose the 2 electrons. And then we demonstrated that when you have a beryllium atom, it has how many protons? It has 4 protons, so there are 1, 2, 3, 4 protons there in the nucleus, and it has 5 neutrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 4 electrons, so 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this is a neutral beryllium atom. Why? Because it doesn't have a charge. Let's look at the charge. The net charge is 0. Why? Because the number of positive charges is 4, and the number of electrons or negative charges is also 4. And the mass number we said is 9. Now, to get the symbol, rather to form a stable beryllium atom, which is now called a ion, this neutral atom has to lose these 2 outermost electrons, this one and the last one. So supposing it loses this electron and also loses this other electron, so what remains now is the number of protons, the number of positive charges being 4, and the number of negative charges or electrons being 2 only. So there are 2 extra positive charges. So in whole, you now realize that the beryllium atom is no longer a neutral atom. It is now a positively charged ion. And its symbol now changes. It will now have a positive 2 charge there. Okay? So in your papers, you are not going to write positive 2. You are going to write 2 positive. It is still the same. 2 positive. So you write the figure first, followed by the symbol of the positive. Okay? Now, to look at a summary of cation formation, or what cations are, we said cations are positively charged ions. Okay? And they are formed when metal atoms lose electrons. So when you have a metal atom losing electrons, it forms a cation, a positively charged ion. We said that some non-metal atoms can also lose electrons. For example, hydrogen atom, which forms hydrogen ion. And ammonium ion is also a non-metal cation. Okay? Then, we said that the number of positive charges on the cation represents the number of electrons the neutral atom lost. For example, we said that for this beryllium, for beryllium atom to be stable, we say that it should lose 2 electrons. Let's first have a beryllium atom here. it has four protons in the nucleus, and it has five neutrons in the nucleus. And then it has four electrons in the energy levels. And the fourth one is there. We said for this atom to become stable, it should lose these two electrons. How does it lose? Let me remove this electron and that electron. You realize that there are only now two electrons that are left there. And when you look at the net charge on that atom, is now going to be positive 2. It lost 2 electrons, which were here, and now the charge on the atom is positive 2. So that means that the number of positive charges on a cation is the same as the number of electrons it has lost. It is also the same as its valency, meaning that the valency of this beryllium atom is 2. It lost 2 electrons, it got a positive 2 charge, and its valency is 2. Then it is also the same as the group number of that element in the periodic table. That shows that the beryllium atom, or beryllium as an element, belongs to group 2 in the periodic table. It lost 2 electrons, it gained a positive 2 charge, its valency is 2, and its group number is 2 in the periodic table. So all group 2 elements in the periodic table will have a positive 2 charge, they will lose 2 electrons, their valency will be 2. So you can apply this in such a question. Write the symbols of the ions formed by each of the following elements. Calcium element or calcium atom. So what you just need to do is to come in the periodic table, look for where is the symbol calcium, which group does it belong to. So calcium is capital C, lowercase a, it belongs to this group, it is over here. So it is in group 2. So how many electrons will it lose? It will lose 2 electrons. And what will it be its valency? 2. And therefore, what is the symbol of calcium? It will have a positive 2 charge. So it will be capital C. It will be capital C, lowercase a, and 2, and positive. This is now the calcium ion. Cesium ion. Just look at the symbol. Do you see? Capital C, S. Look for it in the periodic table. It is over here. This is in group 1. Okay? This is in group 1. So that means that its valence is 1. It loses 1 electron. The number of positive charges on it will be positive 1. And therefore, its symbol will be capital C, lowercase s, then positive. Remember that we said we don't write the 1. This positive sign is enough. It's just enough to show that it's positive 1. Okay? So you are going to do this last one. And then you will complete with this activity, where you are supposed to show how each of these ions are formed. Sodium ion, aluminium ion, and magnesium ion. So in the next lesson, we shall look at anions, which are actually the opposite of cations. Thank you and have a blessed time.